Hello friends, welcome to this course on ANSYS Workbench. In this lecture, we are going to perform an analysis of a clutch plate. As we already know, clutch plate is used in the transmission of automobile cars and bikes. And here we can see in this preview, we have a clutch plate. So onto this clutch plate, we are applying a pressure of 1 megapascal. And now we need to check for the boundary condition of the clutch plate. Now to apply the boundary condition of the clutch plate, we need to understand the assembly of clutch plate. To understand the assembly, here we can see the clutch plate is made of different materials. So it has been made for asbestos, sintered metal, cement, ceramic, Kevlar, etc. So these are all the alloys of the metal, and these are all the tensile strength for different types of metal. We have Poisson's ratio, Young modulus and density. In this lecture, we are going to perform the analysis for the material that is asbestos. You can also perform the analysis for other materials by yourself. But before going to the analysis of the clutch plate, let's go to the assembly of clutch plate system. So right now I am in the HyperMesh software, which is a very popular software for the analysis. So what I do here, we can see I have opened the clutch plate assembly. So I can go to this model. So you don't need to install the software. I am just showing you the assembly of clutch plate system. So before this, I will go to tools, color, and then I will select auto color and then solid. So this is the complete clutch plate system. Now inside this clutch plate assembly, we can see we have these two clutch plate, and generally the main purpose of the clutch plate is to provide engagement or disengagement while we shift the gears or we apply the brakes. And when the load is applied in the clutch plate system, this cover of the clutch plate pushes the plates. So that is why we can see all the load that is applied onto the inside part of the plate. So let's go to the different components here. Here we have the plates. We can see we have the separation between these plates, and we have all the complete assembly. So basically, we are going to perform the analysis for a single plate. So I will go to this single plate here. So here we can see we have this single plate, and the pressure is applied onto this part of the face. On the other side, we can see we have this type of structure. So generally, these types of fins are provided for the thermal simulation. So whenever we use the clutches, the clutch gets heated. So this types of geometry is provided so it can cool properly. And generally the clutch plate is made of very highly friction material so that it can provide a smooth functioning of the plates. So now let's go to ANSYS and we can perform the analysis. So I will go to ANSYS from here. I will go to static structural, pick this and drag it. I will go to this arrow, and then I can click rename this. So this is clutch plate. Give it some name like clutch plate. I will go to this engineering data, right click and click on edit. So I will create a new material from here. I will go to this asbestos. This is asbestos. Press enter. And then go to isotropic elasticity. Pick and drag this. So the value of Young modulus for the asbestos is 165 gigapascal. So we can convert it to megapascal. I will select megapascal and then 165,000. Press enter. The value of Poisson's ratio is 0.28. Press enter. and then I click cancel. I will go to geometry, right click, and then go to import. I will go to browse. In your project file, you go to the folder of clutches and you can see the file that is clutchplate.stp file. Select this file and click on open. So we have imported the geometry. I will go to model, right click, and click on edit. So a new window will open. So here we can see we have inserted the clutch plate. So we will continue this in the next lecture. So in this lecture, we will continue the analysis of the clutch plate. So till now we had imported the model here. Now what I do is I will go to this geometry and then I will click on this clutch assembly option. Here we need to apply the proper material. So I click on this arrow and select asbestos. And then I will go to meshing, right click and click on generate mesh. So by default a meshing has been created. I will click on this arrow and click on hide. So now we have a proper view. So once again we can change the size of meshing from here. So let's say size I am taking 5 and then mesh, right click and update. So the mesh size is very similar to the older mesh and we can see these small features has been captured properly. So we can take this mesh size of 5 and you can also reduce the element size and you can check the mesh. After that we need to apply the load and boundary condition into this. I will go to static structure, right click and click on pressure. I'm going to apply the pressure load here. So we need to apply the pressure load onto this side. Value of pressure is 1 megapascal. Here we need to make sure the face is selected in the geometry and select this face and click on apply. Similarly, we need to apply the boundary condition. So go to structure, right click, insert, and then go to fix support. The fixed support is provided onto this inner faces. So in the geometry, select this face, hold down the control key, and then select this second face. Click apply. So the load and boundary conditions are applied. I will go to solution, right click. I want deformation. Once again, I want one missile stress. So let's calculate the value of stresses. So click on solve. Now we can go to total deformation and we can see the deformation here. So I will go to this animation and you can see how it is going to bend. Similarly, I will need equivalent stress. So click on this and let's check the location of maximum stress. So make a click on this result option and then maximum stresses. So maximum stresses we can find out here. So this is the location for maximum stress. We can also view the animation of stress plot, how the stress is increasing. So the maximum stress into this analysis is 184. Now let's go to calculations. Here we can see the maximum load the asbestos material can take is 800 megapascal and our value is coming out that is very closer to 180. So it means the material is safe. If this value will be more than 800, then the material will break, but right now it is much lesser, so it will not break. So you can continue performing the analysis for different materials like sintered, cerment, ceramic, Kevlar, etc.